Thank you so much for coming. I'm going to be your consultant on the residential apartment complex building project. Okay, great. I have quite a few things I want to go over with you, so how about I serve us some tea and cookies so we can have some brain food while we go through all these things. Okay, give me 1 minute. Is black tea okay? Get started on this. It's a big project, and I'm really just here to make sure that you're having all the bases covered, all the good design technique reminders incorporated into the wonderful apartment complex that your company is building. Okay. So I'm just going to get some information. And can I get the architect's name? Jennifer Taylor. She's wonderful. And the neighborhood location as well. That I want to get. Is this going to be a strictly residential building? Or are we going to have commercial retail locations on the first, second floors? Okay. Residential. Did you send me over the blueprint drawings? Okay, that's fine. Just gonna look at them really quick. I think I saved them. Okay, so it looks like we have an interior courtyard design. A lot of fantastic opportunities for landscaping with this type of design. We do need to keep in mind proper drainage for the courtyard. The annual rainfall of Beartown is actually quite high, so we're looking at generally high annual rainfall amounts. So proper drainage needs to be a top priority. And what sort of parking situation we're looking at. Underground parking, that's ideal. That's definitely where the proper drainage is going to be even more important. Okay. You guys are also looking to do some solar panels. Any sun survey done on the location yet? No? Okay. Well, we're definitely going to need to prioritize a solar survey to make sure that the solar panels are going to be a worthwhile addition. As I said, the annual rainfall amounts are pretty high in Beartown, so that means we're not going to be getting quite a lot of sun in these days, so we're going to have to reassess the addition of the solar panel. General site location, how many other apartment buildings are in that area? A few, okay. And are there primary residential apartments or are there commercial aspects to that? Residential, commercial locations are approximately how far from this? There's a grocery store that's nearby. Okay. Trader Joe's. Okay. And what are we looking at with public transportation? Train and bus access. Okay. So, how many floors? And what's the maximum street setback that we're going to be allowed? That's quite generous. Going to be very nice for the people on the first floor. Going to definitely give us a good amount of visual privacy, but have we assessed whether the 20 meters is excessive, or what are we thinking about that? We're looking at perhaps quite a bit amount of of landscaping in the front of the building versus at the back of the building. Okay. Landscaping in the front. Getting a decent amount of sun access within that courtyard. I think we can definitely consider some type of trees which have a very tall canopy. Be really nice for the courtyard to consider it. Wait, who is the landscape designer? Let me get that information. Okay. Trees. An assessment of the overall neighborhood character that we're looking at. I know Beartown has quite some very pretty historic districts if we're looking at a very modern type of apartment building. It might stand out in a negative way against that backdrop. So, historic district. This is going into the historic district. Okay. I know I've seen quite a few of Taylor's designs before, and she does some very charming brick masonry type of architectural designs. So, being in the historic district, we can expect something maybe with a more brick design. Since we still need to do the solar survey, the sun overview, sun access, how close approximately is this building going to be to other apartment buildings? Okay, so we do get quite a generous distance between other apartment buildings. That's right. I can see why you haven't completed the solar survey yet. I think with quite a large distance, a lot of the apartment buildings are going to have almost ideal sun access. So we know the midwinter sun is the most important. Community garden. That's definitely going to give you enough space to make a community garden. And is the waste storage space going to be in the parking? I would also advise, since there is going to be the community garden space, that we could even add a composting area to the waste storage space. I think that can add quite a little bit of charm and feeling that the residents are doing good and contributing to their immediate surroundings. I think that could be really, really helpful and helpful for the community garden. We can have a really nice, clearly marked area in the waste storage. Blueprints. see that we have really good cross ventilation. Even looking at 70% cross ventilation, that's fantastic. We're always trying to at least reach the aim of 60%, so 70% is really, really good. Okay, I am seeing a slight issue. I really would like to consider adding another meter to the ceiling height of the first floor units. The reason I think that is because I'm foreseeing quite a lush landscaping, and with the first floor units having such a low relative ceiling, the sun access they're going to get is going to be a little bit too limited in my view. So yeah, I think that's going to be a good addition to that. I think at least maybe 1 meter additional to this ceiling height of the first floor units. The size dimensions of all the units are perfect. Though I think the balconies could definitely use just a little bit more square meters, just because with a lot of the rainy days that Beartown gets, I think just that extra space will make the balcony area a lot more comfortable, especially for residents who want to spend time out on their balcony during rainy days, or, you know, it can be nice to maybe put your grill outside and have a little cookout on your balcony during a rainy day, as long as you have the space for it. And sometimes with the rain comes wind, so even though I could see that the balconies are at least exceeding the minimum size, I think the wind plus the rain lead to discomfort using the balcony during most days when you want to use it. So I really like the diverse offerings of the unit. Big plus, especially in this lovely neighborhood where you're going to have families, you're going to have young people, singles moving all into the same building. It's going to facilitate a diverse community and make it more accessible for people in all states. seeing any strict information about this, about some of the fixtures. So I would like to heavily encourage a universal design principle, just because it makes the units a lot more accessible for families with young children, as well as the oldest members of our society. So we're looking at fixtures that are easy to access, ways to reduce tripping hazards entering into the bathrooms, or any room for that matter, going out on the balcony, making sure those are level without trips, and supporting open circulation. With the landscape design, I see that hasn't been exactly completed yet, so I will say that I always heavily encourage planting native species. That's always just going to encourage native animals as well to move into the area, native birds to utilize those outside spaces, and that's always just a plus for the residents to see a lot of wildlife there when they're enjoying a walk around their apartment complex in the courtyard, or just sitting out on the balcony as well. Check that I went through everything. Plant water contacts better. And use movement access for the other servicing pedestrians and glass. The block of the landscape open space limitations. Noise is not going to be such an issue if that's with the sun survey, I think a wind analysis should also be. So it should also be completed. think maybe, I know this is a very large consideration, but perhaps including a second underground parking floor instead of just one parking floor. I know that would be an absolutely massive change, but something to consider with the number of units. I think that two parking floors will give enough space for guest parking as well as unit parking. I think maybe you're expecting a lot of families with small children to be moving in, but you might be surprised with such a very popular area. You might have young people with roommates together, and they might need more parking options. So I think it opens up your tenant base quite a bit with the two parking floors. I think with these considerations, you guys can complete your rendering, so that would be the next step for sure. And then we're looking at the construction. The catalogs that I'm going to be sending home with you. These are catalogs featuring some of the most new and improved building materials that are available on the market. Of course, we're going to be looking at the brick and mortar facade, but in the inside, going to recommend the steel reinforced concrete. See the recommended setups for that. I will admit this is not my area of expertise, but these products are highly, highly recommended by my consultation. See the application of them. So forth in this catalog. The max. Be sending this one home with you, of course. Okay. And then right here I have a catalog of many different types of products, insulations. These are all sold in kind of more small base applications, but they're also available in large scale construction applications. These obviously would be too small for the type of building project you're working on. But all sorts of grades. Being in Baritone with all that rain, we're definitely going to recommend a very strong insulation to keep the chill out of those buildings. You can see there's quite a wide range of products. You don't have to be stuck with one thing. You can pick what's going to suit the building type and the area. So, send you home with these catalogs. And we're not paid to promote these products or anything. I just highly recommend these companies in particular. Okay, so I'll be sending you my full report. Actually, I have a couple of other things. I'm going to analyze the blueprints, make sure that they fit in with all of the minimum and recommended requirements for sizing of everything. And then I will send you the finished report. Okay. Thank you so much for coming in and choosing me to do your